When building things in Angular, have you ever found yourself with the need to animate markup as it physically enters and leaves the DOM? This isn't possible, right? Actually, it is. In Angular, we have access to a powerful animation framework. It's packed with many features that just aren't possible, at least at the moment, with CSS by itself. In this video, we're going to dive into one such feature, the ability to animate markup as it's added and removed from the document with the enter and leave aliases. All right, let's get to it. Okay, before we get too far into it, if you haven't watched my previous video on the basics of Angular animations, you'll probably want to check it out first. We covered how to include the animations module and some of the basics of the API, so if you're not familiar with these concepts, the examples in this video might not make much sense. Okay, onto the example for this video. Here's the application that we're starting with. Currently, our menu is always in the DOM, and we're transitioning it as it opens and closes using the Angular state-based animation that we added in the previous video. In this example, we're actually going to change this logic so that the menu will be removed from the DOM when it's closed and added when it's opened. One way to do this is wrap our menu in an if statement. For this, we'll start by adding a new Boolean property called menuOpen, and we'll initialize it to false. Now we'll add our if statement around our menu component, and the condition will be the value of our new menuOpen property. Now let's go ahead and remove the old menuState property because we're going to switch to our new Boolean property instead. Now, on our page content component, menuClickEvent, we'll instead set our menuOpen value to true. And on our menu component, closeEvent, we'll set it to false. This will properly handle the display toggling for the menu. Also, we can leave the open-close animation trigger on our menu component, but we'll unbind it from our old property. Okay, let's save and make sure this is working correctly. Okay, it's still opening and closing correctly, but it's not transitioning like we want. We need to change our animation to handle this first. We can leave our old states here for now as a reference, and we'll add another transition method. This time we're going to use the enter alias for our state change expression. It may be obvious, but in case it's not clear, this will allow the menu to transition as it enters the DOM. Okay, then we have our array of animations. First, we'll pass the state that we want our menu to animate from when it enters. We're going to want to start translate it out of view and then transition it into its final open spot. So we'll use the style method and pass a transform value of translate x 120%. Next, we add the animate method. The first parameter will be our duration and easing function as a string, so 1 second and easing function of ease in. And for the second parameter, we need to pass it the value that we want to animate to. So we'll use the style method again, and we'll pass a transform with a translate x value of 0 this time. Okay, so that's the animation for when it enters. Next, we need to handle when it leaves. For this, let's copy the enter transition. Now we'll use the leave alias this time. And for our from state, let's switch this to 0. And for our to state, we'll leave the duration and easing as is. And we'll switch the translate x to 120%. Now we can remove our old states and transitions too, since we're no longer using them. Okay, that's it. Let's save and take a look. Nice. Now it transitions again as it opens. And when we click on the shield, it eases out as it closes. When you sit back and think about this, it's really pretty cool. The markup is injected into the document and immediately transitioned to its open state. And then on the flip side, when it's closed, it isn't removed from the document until the animation completes. Pretty neat. Something else we can do here is simplify this code a little with a few variables. Let's add a variable called hidden and put our style object for our hidden state as the value. Then we can replace the two instances of this style with the variable. Next, let's add a variable for our visible state and give it our visible style object. Then we'll replace these instances with our visible variable. And then let's create one more variable for our animation duration and timing string. And then we'll replace both instances with this variable too. There, not a huge difference, but that will make it easier to maintain in the long run. Okay, so now you should have the ability and know-how to animate items as they're added and removed from the DOM in Angular. Now, like I mentioned in the last video on Angular animations, there's a lot to the animation framework. So I'll go ahead and stop here for now, but I will be creating several more videos covering much more on Angular animations very soon. I hope this was helpful. Until next time, thanks for watching.